Ratchet? Ratchet, are you all right?
Clank? Clank, is that you? Clank!
Ratchet, are you okay? You swallowed an awful lot of water.
Please, it'll take more than a few space pirates to stop me. Come on, let's check out the island.
My booster pack can only carry one of us. Do your grab boots still work?
Are you out there?
Darkwater's dead, and there are no zombies.
Hey, he sent us here for a reason. There has to be some kind of connection.
The drawbridge is rusted shut. Hey, maybe you can use your wrench's kinetic tether. Think you can handle this one? Nice job, Ratchet. Come on, I'll race.
Hey there, young fella. Welcome to Hulafar Island. My name's Barnabas Whirly. Mayor Barnabas Whirly, to be precise. What brings you here? A tourist? Here? Not much to see now, I'm afraid. Lost our power thanks to a mysterious saboteur.
We're trying to contact a friend of ours, but I can't seem to catch a signal. I don't suppose you have a radio tower we could use.
Sorry, miss. We had a supply beacon, but someone vandalized it last night. But if you help us repair it, I'm sure you'd be able to contact your friend. Really? Well, that is good news. Just climb to the top of each wind turbine and give the old boat crank a turn.
Check out the wind turbine. I'll head to higher ground. If I can catch a signal, maybe we can ask Pete what we're supposed to be looking for.
Oh, dang, Nabby. This is the third time this year these old wind turbines have stopped working. It's sabotage, I tell you. Someone's been messing with my equipment. Problem is, these here wind turbines are about the only thing keeping the juice flowing through the island. No juice, no beacon. No beacon, no supplies. You follow? Anyways, my brother-in-law was supposed to come back and help repair these turbines, but he probably went fishing instead. Think you could help a feller out. I'd do it myself, but I don't much care for heights. Oh, I'd sure appreciate it, stranger. Couple of good turns on that bolt crank up there ought to get her going again. Good luck. Some shady character who's been hanging around the beach. Tall feller. Annoying parrot. Always see him palling around with them pirates. Darkwater. Sorry, stranger, we don't talk about him round these parts on account of the curse. Well, yeah, the curse of the undead. Although, I'm not exactly sure how you can be undead. I suppose it just means alive. Oh, now I've gone and confused myself.
Oh!
more wind turbines, and we'll be back in business.
Do they have any leads?
No. So far, the only thing they've been able to find are red feathers.
Low-down, good-for-nothing vandals. When's that mayor gonna crack down on these bumps? Some wise guy uncoupled the flipping energy conductor from the supply beacon. How am I supposed to fix it without power? Guess I'll just have to take lunch. Appreciate the offer, kid, but we can't do nothing till the power's restored. Lucky for me, I'm in the union.
Incredible! Lost 20 to win. But man, what a fight!
Well, they're talking about a curse.
A curse? Come on, Tal. There's no such thing.
I'm sure it's nothing. I'll do some more digging and get back to you.
Who's here? Small galaxy, ain't it?
Ah, too small! Ah!
So, what brings you to Murdergraw, friend? Well, what are the odds? I'm here for a little relaxation myself.
Ah, playing low! Ah!
Well, if you need anything, you give me a holler. I just might have something useful for you. Know what I mean?
Thank you. Did you see we got the power working? That's good old-fashioned union labor for you. Don't thank me, though. I'm just a guy on a job. Afraid not. Looks like some bum stole the bolt straight off the power coupling. I can't connect the darn thing. The nerve of some people. Anyways, if you're looking to get a signal off the island, you'll have to find another bolt. I think I saw someone selling one down by the beach. Zony, huh? Come to think of it, all Angstrom used to jabber on about them. Said they were the watchers of the universe, or some such gobbledygook. Oh, a wise guy, huh? Yeah, make you feel big, picking on a working-class Joe such as myself? For shame.
Looks like it's missing a standard Grummel Net versatile.
Howdy, friend. Now, what can I do for you? Well, what do you know? I happen to have one right here, procured by perfectly legal means, of course.
Bob, with a crowbar!
How about we make ourselves a deal? Here you go. I'll see you around, partner.
One. Nice going, kid. Local Beacon Union 319 thanks you for your charitable contribution. Here we go. Just put this on here. See if you can give it a good turn there, champ. I do it myself, but I'm on break. Union rules, you understand.
Young Lombax, I give you the Obsidian Eye, the most powerful Lorentzian telescope in the universe. It was created with lenses carved from obsidian glass and powered by a single fulcrum star. Darkwater built it himself so as to keep in contact with his little friends.
Can it tell me where they are?
Well, sure, if we have a fulcrum star to activate it. Here, I took the liberty of borrowing this from our archives. They're pages from Darkwater's personal journal.
Cabin's log, the 3rd of August. My trip to the Brager Star Cluster was fraught with savings. Not only did I find a great place for cheap Krull cobbler, but I also met a mysterious race called the Zuni. Friendly little creatures they are, can manipulate time and space to their will. Their leader gave me a fulcrum star I can use to talk to them with once I return to Polaris. It's worth a fortune, but I wouldn't part with it for all the bolts in Meridian City. The only worry is me miserable first mate Slag. It's only a matter of moons before he tries to pillage me property. But I've taken steps to defend it well into the afterlife using an ancient Terrachnoid incantation and a coupon for one free curse at the Hulafar Magic Emporium. I'll forever bind me soul to me body so that I may protect the Fulcrum Star. He who disturbs me shall disturb my entire crew. This I swear.
That star ought to be locked away with the rest of Dark Water's treasure. Find that star, and you'll find your friend.
Ratchet, I think I'm getting a signal.
Rusty Pete to Lumbax, I have crucial information about Captain Darkwater. I'm dropping anchor at the Hulafar Pier. Over and out.
Well, it's about time, mate. I've been radioing you all night. So have you found the Obsidian Eye yet?
Yeah, but it doesn't work. Darkwater hid the Fulcrum Star.
Not surprising. Cheap old Beanrake never did trust anyone. Of course, we were trying to kill him at the time. Good news is, every pirate worth their salt keeps a map to their buried treasure.
A map? Well, where is it?
Well, that's the bad news. It's probably still with his body over in Morrow Caverns. Tell you what, mate, why don't you let me help you find it? What? Can't a pirate who's never told the truth in his life go blatantly out of his way to help the Lumbax who killed his best friend and captain? Great! And I have just the pirate to help us. Ta-da! I call it Slag on a Stick. Rerouted his memory banks to his vocal processor, so he'll remember anything he's looking at. Now climb aboard, mateys, and put your faith in good old Captain Slag. And so, Hero set forth to Morrow Caverns in search of a map to the mythical Fulcrum Star. With him was Rusty Pete, a noble and true corsair, adored by women across the galaxy.
This be a work of fiction.
Do you even know where we're going?
Of course I do. I got GPS. Look.
Turn right at Isle of Despair. In 5 leagues, keep left.
I love this thing. Hanukkah gift from me mom, it was.
Arriving at destination on right.